Hey everyone, it's Melanie Bart Studio 320, and this week I have a special video just for you on a staining technique I did just 2 weeks ago on the two end tables I did. If you haven't checked out that video yet, go check that out and then come back to this video for a deeper dive. I am going to focus just on the tops of the tables, and I'm going to give you a step-by-step look at how to do the staining technique and the colors I used, and a little bit about how to be creative in your own way. Stick around. I have a tinted stain, and it's a worn navy, a gel stain in the color Kona, and that's a dark color. This is the antique Walnut by General Finishes. This is also a gel stain, and you can see it's lighter than the Kona. And this one is a combination of Brazilian rosewood and I believe cherry. It's probably a good idea to label the lid. I'm going to have four different cloths, one for each color stain. I'm going to start with one color and lay them out, and then the second color, third color, and then the fourth color. So I'm only going to work with one color at a time. So I'm going to start with my custom made stain that I should have labeled. Now, I probably will get some stain on here, but no worries. I can clean it off with mineral spirits, no problem. And because this is a fusion all-in-one, it's even easier to remove. Because I'm just gonna drag my cloth. Now, you could do this with a brush as well, but I have found that you have way more control when you're using a cloth. But again, that is something you have to decide on it your own. All right, I'm gonna just give it one wipe, even it out, and now I'm gonna go on the other side. Now this is my lightest stain, so I decided that I'm going to put that on the edges, and that's just, there was no great thought in that, that's how I decided to apply it. I already applied this to this little trim on the other end table. So that gave me kind of an idea of how I wanted to construct the top. Now I may end up making more stripes, but I'm gonna start with this, and I'm gonna go into the middle. Made the center one a little wider, and of course I can change that as I go. I'm going to take the antique walnut and I'm going to put it here. Now as you go to the second end table, don't worry about it being exactly the same. This isn't meant to be cookie cutter creations. This is meant to be creative out of your own head, out of your own heart and soul, whatever you like. There's no rules here. This is how it looks good to you. But don't feel like you have to follow a certain regimen as far as being creative. I like the dark, so I am gonna, I'm gonna put it right here. I'm gonna put it on the same place on the other side. Now, you don't have to do this like the same coming in. It's just better for me to have some kind of plan. I don't know, sometimes chaos is fine for me, and sometimes it's not. I have to do what I want to do, period. I'm going to take the Kona, which is the darkest one, and I'm gonna make a small line down either side here. And again, this is my design. You do your design. You do, not that you can't do my design. I'm just saying, you do what you wanna do. There's no right or wrong. Do your own thing. Do what's good for you. And that sounds selfish, but we're talking creativity here. Be creative in your own way and celebrate that. Where's she gonna put the blue? You'll see. So I'm gonna take the lighter one again and fill this in. And then I'm gonna come back and put in some blue. Now the lighter color I think is good for blending. Definitely subtle, which is good, at least for me. I want it to be subtle. I just want it to add a little bit of dimension and interest. Something unexpected. Okay, I think I'm good with that. I like that. All right, so I'm absolutely horrified at what it looks like around because I need some mineral spirits. So let's do that now so you get to see that as well. And I'm using Green Envy. It's mineral spirits. There's all sorts of different brands. This one is considered odorless, and that's pretty true. Let me get this where you can see it. Okay. You can see how easily the mineral spirits takes off the stain. Now remember, I say this all the time, paint first, stain second, because then you can do this. Well, friends, that's all I have for you this week. I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope it helped to clarify since we slowed it down a little bit. You know, when I'm doing these videos and they're 20 minutes long and I'm creating an entire piece, sometimes I don't get a chance to explain every single detail. And that's when I pull those parts out and make a video all on its own. So I hope that helped. And I hope it's inspired you to take this technique and make it your own in your own creative way. Thanks for being here. See you next time.
You can do it.